I worked 2 years after my bachelor's degree in Ghana. And after the 2 years, I felt, okay, it's about time I go back to school and add some knowledge to my skills. And I decided to go for finance because it was the closest to what I was doing in my job before.
I have always wanted to work in healthcare, never in other branches. So for me, healthcare is very important.
We are a 24/7 company, so it has to run every day, every night.
Well, I teach, I do research, I'm a professor of management accounting. We have four specializations. One is production, logistics and management, which is about processes in production and logistics and how those can be optimized. So it's about planning, it's about inventories, it's about lead times, it's about efficient use of fixed resources. Second track is financial engineering and management. That focuses on the financial sector and especially about risk management using financial products, very topical issue right now. Third track is information technology and management. There, the use of information technology as a key enabler of the improvement of operational processes is important. And especially if you look at processes in banks, insurance companies, and other organizations where the information system is the backbone, then improving processes in those organizations is all about using those information systems in a smarter way. And fourthly, we have the healthcare technology and management track that focuses on improvement of processes in healthcare and the use of advanced biomedical technology, again, to improve processes as a key enabler. We really look for students with a wide variety of strong quantitative backgrounds who have this orientation towards improvement and pragmatic orientation. They can have a bachelor in engineering, and various kinds of engineering are a very appropriate background for this, but also mathematics, some more quantitative forms of economics, physics, a wide variety of bachelor programs is a great preparation for this master's program.
Well, the transfer from HBO to the university is one of the major challenges you will be facing when you are transferring, especially concerning the amount of work, the amount of slides you have to prepare, pages you have to read, but also concerning the difficulty. It's really really a culture shock when you come to the university from HBO.
I decided to go to Twente because I wanted to study finance and engineering, and I wanted a master that would give me the option to study abroad for one semester. In that 6 months, I went to the University of Sydney in Australia. It was really nice to study in Sydney. It's a great country with a great city and a great university. And it's really nice that that can be part of your program in the Netherlands.
When I made the choice for industrial engineering, I chose that study because it's rather broad, so you can have the possibility to go to work in different fields in the economy. And also in different positions. It can be management, it can be technology, it can be human resource. So there are different situations where you have a perfect background for.
We are quite special in terms of allowing students to come up with their own ideas and to come up with electives, to come up with the ideas about studying abroad, ideas courses they want to take elsewhere at this university. So in terms of the flexibility that we offer in the program and the initiative that we give to students, that's a really deliberate choice in the design of our program. And I think that works really well. And that's kind of unique in the Netherlands. Internship is a vital part of our program. The whole program is 2 years. And the final semester of that is totally spent on the final project and typically on an internship. We like our students, and the vast majority does it that way, to do research in practice, to go to an organization, mostly it's a for-profit company, and work on a real problem that the company is experiencing and be part of a team and contribute to that. Do their own research, come up with recommendations and help implementing these things.
I'm here with another colleague and we're working on a big project concerning MRI scanners, and my part of it is about cost model. We're trying to estimate the cost of MRI scanners, the activities that is involved in the scanning process. We're trying to get a cost of each activities, and we want to see how that cost could be reduced.
I think the fun is, well, first of all, it's, of course, it has something to do with your background. Economics, business economics is basically what I've done in my during my studies and also during my career in the past 25 years or so. And Rabobank is a great organization to be. I always have had, a thin but a link with the university. I'm still a part-time professor, very much part-time to be fair. But from the very much from the start, I have been have had this relationship with the faculty, with the university. Did my courses, had my students, graduation and PhD students. So yeah, it has been a very beneficial relationship, both from a Rabobank's perspective, but I also think from a university's perspective.
It's a broad program, so we see students going to very different careers and positions.
I think the career opportunities are clearly good. There's not a whole lot to go for. But as I mentioned, there are a lot of students from Twente at different jobs within Rabobank. Oh, by the way, not only in Rabobank, also within other financial institutions around, both domestically as well as internationally. In very, very senior roles in finance, in risk, in treasury. So, I think there are a lot of opportunities.
We are an organization with nursing homes, facilities for care and living, and home care. My function here is a region manager. I'm responsible for the care in the half of Enschede. And my responsibilities are also on results. So I have a target that I have to make, a financial target, so that we have a healthy organization. I think I've realized my dream that I had as a little girl, at least for the most part. When I finished my education, I started in an organization for mentally disabled people, and I was a general employee. So I did a little bit of policies, and I helped create policies. Just a very nice job to have when you just finished your school. Then I got a management position at Oldekotte, which is a forensic psychiatric clinic here in the neighborhood. That was my first contact with management, and I had to manage. And I did it for 2.5 years, and then I started here.
Cheap Tickets is an online company that sells mainly flight tickets, but also hotels, car rentals, and package holidays. My responsibility is ICT and processing. That means that I'm responsible for all web sites, also the internal processes. The most joy in my work is actually working together with ambitious people and getting results that we are expecting, or even better than we expected it. All the elements that I learned in Twente are part of my business. Of course, I'm also an entrepreneur, so I have the financials, the human resource, the technology. It is travel, but it is a lot of technology here also. So I see the different parts are daily on my desk. You can be a specialist as an industrial engineer, but you can also be more on the general level, like a management job. And also in different, you can go into, let's say, the travel industry,
but you can also go to a bank or the government services. So the choices are quite big. So there's always a good job for good people who studied industrial engineering.